Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the second episode of Video Game Bang. I'm your host, Corey Vincent, along with my faithful sidekick, Aaron
sidekick.
Carter.
That's what we're going with. Yeah, hello, everybody.
I can't call you sidekick.
Sidekick, no, because whenever I think of sidekick, I think of Robin, and there's no way I'm wearing yellow.
Let's you're okay with the tiny green shorts, though?
Oh, yeah, I wear tiny green shorts all the time, but the yellow is what really kills the whole thing for me.
I'll see what I can do about that.
Now, how about we don't see what you can do about that?
Episode number two, big 2-0. People thought we weren't going to make it to two. We made it to two.
Yeah, we did.
We may even do a third.
Fourth, maybe.
Fourth? Yeah, I'll do a fourth.
We'll see where it all goes.
So we got some feedback from episode one, and one of the complaints was, the first biggest complaint was, first of all, Aaron's voice was pretty whiny and annoying.
That's impossible.
Number two was the fact that we spent a lot of time talking about the Xbox One and not enough time on the PS4. Now, to correct that, Aaron and I have prepared a list of pros and cons. Mostly cons.
I don't know if we prepared, but we'll go over it. I mean, because we didn't really prepare for the Xbox One. We just knew what we knew, you know, so we're going to be going, you know what we know about the PS4.
Well, inherently, the Xbox One is a superior product, so it's a lot easier to come up with pros.
that's Corey's fanboyism coming out right now for Microsoft.
I'm proud of it.
But the PS4 is definitely, it's a good system. It's its major competitor. So we got to touch on it today. We got to.
So I swear, we're going to get to the PS4. The PS4 is coming, people. Because as you learned from the last episode, on Video Game Bang, we talk about video games and only video games. And today we're talking about the PS4, and we are going to talk about the PS4. But first, I want to know, Aaron, what are you playing?
Right now, I'm not playing anything, like a CD based game. I'm playing a lot of digital download stuff. So Minecraft, I actually went back and played a little bit of that Spartacus game, that free game that you play on, Xbox. I'm only playing the Xbox right now, so it's nothing, no PC games. I don't have a PlayStation 3, so yeah, I'm playing like a lot of digital downloads. I don't do the store bought stuff too much anymore. There's nothing catching me.
We touched a little bit last episode about Slave Fighter 2013. I mean Spartacus. Go ahead, give us your breakdown. What do you think? Should people be downloading it? Should people not be downloading it?
When the game is free, you should download it 100%. There's even no question about it. I mean, it's just hard drive space that you're losing. You're not losing any money. You're playing a free game that's, you know, fun. I'm not a fighter fan by any stretch of the imagination. So Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat, and all that stuff, don't like it. But if it's a free game and it's, you know, in that same vein, then, yeah, I'll give it a try. And it actually was pretty fun. I didn't spend any money on it. So I don't know how many times I can say free in one, you know, outing on this.
So we did mention it was free. So start the download, I suppose. But I remember I've been playing it a little bit too, and you first pitched it to me. You said, "Oh, it's awesome because you can fight against your friends, and then when your fighter dies, he's gone forever." And then you mentioned 2-on-2 fights. Like, what happened?
A little misleading. Yeah, I understand. But I was going off of the description for the game. So whenever you click on the game, it reads you a little small description of what you're going to be getting into, and it said all that stuff. 2v2, online, you know, co-op, and, you know, versus. And so I went into it thinking the same thing. I was preaching the gospel that they were giving me.
But we could confirm that it is not 2-on-2, unfortunately.
I haven't seen it yet, even though it still is in the description. The online is there. You can play versus other people, even though you can't choose your opponent. It's always random. And I guess for good reason. You know, they don't want people just cheating and, you know, trying to get their characters up by playing a friend that has just like a scrub character or something like that.
Well, was there really a level up system? I mean, you get points to buy stuff, but your character doesn't get any better.
No, your character doesn't. But I guess the fact that you win fights and you would get money is, in fact, you leveling up as a I know, a training area or a training school. I mean, so you get more money to buy more gear. Even though you lose that fighter, you could just buy a whole new fighter and then throw your gear onto him, stuff like that.
And of course, if you are really adamant about the game, you can put your real money into it to bypass.
And some people have. Some people have.
Yeah, we know a few.
We'll not mention names. But yeah, definitely some people have.
So Spartacus, and then you said Minecraft.
Of course.
The classic.
Minecraft on the Xbox 360.
And not to give away any spoilers for later in the show, but we may be talking about a little PC versus console action.
And the reason why I chose Minecraft on the Xbox, because I do own it on the PC as well. And the PC is, you know, don't get me wrong, it's phenomenal. They have lots of mods, a lot more things you can do on the PC. The graphics can be bumped up to look better. You can get different skins.
Is there a butt coming? Because this seems...
Oh, like, yeah, there's a huge...
You basically sold me on the PC.
There's a huge butt. But on the Xbox 360, it's easier for me to play because I can just start it up, you know, invite friends easily because I'm on Xbox Live and they're on a friends list on Xbox Live. Mm-hmm. I haven't been a PC gamer and... quite some time, so I don't know if there's any type. There probably is some type of interface where you can have like a friends list and see who's online and so forth. But right now, Xbox puts it all into one neat package, and so I just usually stay on that. I can hop on, invite a friend if they want to play or not, and then of course, there's always I have a controller in my hand. That's going to be mouse and keyboard for me any day.
The people I was playing with on PC Minecraft, which is far superior, I will say, as far as I'm concerned, is the they were purist gamers. So, like, when we first started, we didn't use any of the recipes for the supplies. Mm-hmm. So we would really try. We would just sit there in the crafting menu and then just randomly place sticks and stones and sticks and watermelons just to see what crazy stuff we would come up with. And I don't know, and then when I went to the Xbox version and everything was just kind of laid out for you, it like took some of the RP aspects away from it.
Trying to figure out what everything makes, I think that's for the beginners. You know, that's probably part of
me a beginner.
Oh yeah, definitely. Okay. I think that's for the people that are just trying to figure out the specialty or what's so special about Minecraft. But then once you're past all that and you're, you know, you're just kind of jaded on that stuff, then you just want to be able to just click a button and boom, be able to make, you know, I don't want to have to arrange sticks in a certain pattern just to make a pickaxe. Wow. I want to just click and go. Lazy. So that's what the Xbox is for. It's more streamlined, definitely. And I know that's what they had in mind when they were designing it. So I like the more streamlined approach as opposed to, you know, clicking and doing everything all tediously and stuff.
Yeah. Well, on top of that, I guess what I've been playing is Magic 2014. More and more Magic.
Now, see, why would you play Magic? I guess it's the same type of argument. Why would you play Magic on the Xbox as opposed to just going to a card shop and playing it in real life?
Because with Magic on the Xbox, it's more streamlined.
Oh, yeah.
I can just start it up. And
really?
I got my friends on a friends list. And I can send an invite. Yeah, but I really enjoyed the changes. If you're a Magic player out there,
three people out there?
For the three of you out there who can relate, they made some huge improvements from 2013. The attack all button is awesome. The counters, you don't have to sit there and watch every single counter get added to every single creature. It's more quick, so you can get back to your card fighting action. The storyline is much, much improved.
There's a storyline?
Oh, yeah.
I had no idea.
You are a planeswalker.
Whatever that means.
That's as far as I've ever gotten on that instructional booklet. Everyone starts with, you are a planeswalker. Yeah, but anyways, it's a much improved game. I'd get it. And it's awesome because they that's one thing I really like about Wizards. Is they honor the longtime customers. So it was able to look to see that I played 2013 and I get little bonuses that other people don't get. And then with any Magic game, they give you a code to go to your local comic shop and get your first set of free cards or get some free cards promo.
Oh, I figure they got to keep their fans any way they can.
Yeah, you know, it's pretty awesome. So, that being said, with that segment played.
That one, now that's only exclusive to the Xbox?
No. You're talking about Magic?
Yeah.
No, Magic is on Xbox, PlayStation, Android, and iOS.
That's altogether sad.
Yeah.
They're ruining people's lives on that many platforms.
And you're done. Now, here on Video Game Bang, we like to talk about video games. Is that right, Aaron?
Once in a while.
Yeah. We like to talk about video games. So we're going to talk about it. So this is the dreaded thing. I've been pushing it back. Didn't want to do it. But now we're going to do it. We're going to talk about the PlayStation 4 pros and cons. Aaron, go ahead.
Well, last show we played out the Xbox One, like, all the way out. Just laid out everything, you know. I'm not sure if we're going to go into that much detail with the PS4 because our knowledge is quite limited. But what we do know, and what's the major competition going against the Xbox, is PS4. So far we know it's a powerful console. I think around the web they've been saying it is actually more powerful than the Xbox One.
I will concede to that one. If you were just putting specs against specs, the PlayStation 4 is definitely a little stronger.
But in reality, what does that really mean?
No.
Because the PS3 was technically, I guess, stronger than the Xbox, right?
Way stronger.
Okay, but did anybody ever have that much more fun on the PS3 than the Xbox? Because of the power capability of it.
Not that I could
say. Exactly. It's all about the games. It's all about the games on there. I mean, they have a brand new controller with a little touchpad on there. That's pretty cool. They have a cool little feature on there where you can actually view the gaming of a person on your friends list. So you can spectate.
Yeah.
I like that.
Like Twitch. So Xbox is matching that one with the Twitch. But I was it you that was telling me that with the PlayStation, you could actually take over a friend's game?
That's another thing. You can watch, and then if they want you to just take control of their game, you can just, I guess still with that share button that's on their controller, you can just click that or somehow, but you can take over somebody else's game and play like a little...
Why would I want you to take over my game,
First of all, let's see. So I'm playing a game. Or no, you're playing a game.
Yes.
And we all know...
To perfection.
Yeah, yeah. We all know that you're not as good as I am at certain games. Oh, so you're like, I can't beat this level, Aaron. You know, what do I do? And so I say, sit down, let me take over, and watch how a master does it. And so I take over for you, I beat the little section, I give you the control back, and you cry in the corner because you couldn't beat a simple level on like Assassin's Creed or Prince of Persia or something like that.
So, in reality, back where we're at right now, so I'm an achievement guy. You may or may not have known that. I love achievements.
Mm-hmm.
It's all I do. So, PlayStation has trophies.
Yeah, they've had trophies for some time now.
So, if I'm playing Star Wars Battlefront, and there's an achievement for killing a Jedi, and you take over my game and you kill the Jedi, who gets the points?
I believe you would. I don't think I mean, because it's on your profile that I'd be playing under. It's not like I'm transferring my profile and everything over there to your system. It's still you. It's just I get control.
Okay.
And that's probably what they were thinking as well, is, you know, you can help friends get trophies or just show them some, I guess, cool combo moves. If you're like into a Street Fighter type of game, show them how it's done, you know, or what it looks like. I think it was just a cool feature. They just wanted to show off the power of their system, so they added that in there. I mean, it's not a negative for the system. I think it's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, I could see the potential.
And then maybe also it's a game that you've purchased. I'm not sure how the game is. Maybe I want to, you know if it's a good game. And I get to play a little section of it, a little bigger section of a demo, per se, more in-depth. So, I mean, that's a cool feature. I haven't seen the Xbox do it. I have heard rumor that they were experimenting with something like that to be able to take over control over Skype with using Skype. But right now, I would think that has the edge. PS4 has the edge in that area over the Xbox One.
Now, do we know if PS4 has any exclusive titles?
Oh yeah, they have plenty of exclusive titles. They're going to be
that. Okay, hold on. Let me reword that. Is there any good exclusive titles?
Well, it depends on who you're asking. Is number one, because they have Kingdom Hearts, which I know a lot of people.
That's coming out on the Xbox.
No.
Where have you seen that? Serious as a heart attack, my friend.
Where did you see that at?
The internet.
Yeah, the internet. Yeah, because everything on the internet is true.
No, that's exactly for real. Right. Go to the wiki page for the. If you don't know, wiki is short for Wikipedia. Go to the Wikipedia page, and it's there. And that Final Fantasy that was at the PlayStation 4 show will also be on the Xbox.
But Final Fantasy hasn't been exclusive since like Super Nintendo.
Really?
Yeah. Final Fantasy's on everything now.
Well, PlayStation have a tendency of making it seem like they
have. Because they Final Fantasy 7, 8, 9, I believe, and 10, yeah, they were all exclusives. And I want to say, no, because 11 was the MMO. That was terrible, by the way. So yeah, 7, 8, 9, 10, PS2, or PS1 and 2, you know, shared between those. So that's why PlayStation owners take, real responsibility.
And they got God of War, too. Did they announce a new God of War?
If they didn't, they will.
Yeah,
that's their Halo.
It's their bread and butter.
Yeah, that's their...
Hey, but there is a kill zone.
There is a kill
zone. I'm trying here, people. I'm really trying.
But see, for somebody that hasn't played the PlayStation 3,
yeah,
it's like you're not going to know what the exclusives are because you really didn't care. You didn't need to care at the time. But yeah, Killzone is one of their... Killzone is their Halo.
Yeah, Killzone's definitely their Halo. And you know they're going to make a sequel of this Last of Us. They're going to run it into the ground.
Oh, yeah, because it got crazy reviews. I think IGN gave it like a perfect 10.
How do they do that? Last of Us 2, The Rest of Us, the All But One?
I don't know. So I have a coworker, and she says it's like watching a movie. Like, I've heard that before with video games, but she said she literally just sits down and she plays it, and she's like, she's so enthralled with the cutscenes and the acting in the cutscenes that she doesn't, you know, want to go back to the actual gameplay. And I'm like, well, that's kind of hard to swallow there. But I've never played the game. I've seen people play it online. Like, I've watched Twitch feeds of it. But, and it looks good. But definitely, if it sells well, they're going to make a sequel.
My most victorious moment as a Microsoft fanboy through the E3 was when PlayStation 4 announced that it's going to be paid subscription to their online services.
But they needed that.
Oh, heck yeah.
Yeah. I don't think they were going to go another cycle with making it free and then have their system shut down by Anonymous or something like that again. Yeah, they needed to get some money off of that.
They were getting hacked left and right. Every time I attempted to play a game on PlayStation servers, multiplayer, it was usually a bad experience, with the exception of DCU when I did play that for like 2 weeks.
It seemed like the competition was a little... I'm probably going to get a lot of hate on this one. The competition was weaker on the PlayStation 3. I played Call of Duty. My brother has a PlayStation 3, and he constantly plays Call of Duty. And I've taken the controller from him and played a couple of times, and it's just like, where's all the competition at?
Oh, yeah. I got friends of mine from high school. They're not going to listen to this. So, yeah, they post like their big shots with their 30 and 3 or whatever records.
Killstreak, yeah.
I say, bring it. Bring it to the Xbox.
It's, I don't know. It seems
have
like
my boy D lay something down on you.
It's like, seems like a whole bunch of, I don't know, just like part-time players, I guess. And then on Xbox, you got the more hardcore first-person shooters.
Yeah. Sorry, PlayStation. There's no competition.
But besides the shooters and action games, I mean, I don't know what else is exclusive. I saw that they're actually going to start... doing a lot more indie games on the PS3. So, I mean, I'm big into the indie game scene, you know, like anything. And not even, there's a lot of indie games on the computer, and those are more well put together than the ones on the Xbox that I play, which are just, you know, terrible at times, but I still like, you know, supporting the little independent games. If you haven't, there's a game called, I made a game with zombies in it on Xbox 360. I would download it.
You didn't make a game with zombies
in it. No, I didn't make a game with zombies in it, but somebody did.
Oh, that's the name of the game.
And that's the name of the game. I made a game with zombies in it. It cost $1.
Okay.
I would download it because it's just for the soundtrack alone. It's good.
Hmm. Interesting. You know, on Video Game Bang, we like to talk about video games. And which brings us to our next topic. See, we tried this new thing out last time. We got a lot of hate. No, we didn't get a lot of hate, but we got some hate. We got some people saying, you know, you guys didn't talk about the video games. Where's the video games? You guys talked about Zimmerman. We talked about little people. We talked about the Glee guy dying.
Oh, yeah, but that was just, like, brought up right then and there. Like, nobody suspected he would die during our show. Maybe we caused that. That's terrible.
You know, to think that. That some butterfly effect has spawned out of this room. I did leave the window open.
That would be terrible.
Well, the next thing we'd like to talk about is MMOs on the console. Good or bad idea? I'm going to go ahead and start on this one.
Okay, all right.
I think it's a fantastic idea. I think the only reason it hasn't been good so far is the fact that we were limited by hardware and online capacity. So I don't know exactly what PlayStation is doing, but I know that the Xbox is going from, what, 15,000 servers up to 200,000 servers?
Some incredible number some like that,
ridiculous number. The amount of servers that was used to run everything that we know in the world in 1999 was, I think, was what they threw out there. So I think with the new hardware capabilities, it's going to be good. And but I'm really hoping that they allow for the mouse and keyboard people to use those peripherals.
They won't.
Is that confirmed, or are you just talking off the top of your head?
I'm talking off the top of my head, only because if they're going to go that far to let mouse and keyboard be attached to your system, then why not do it for the first-person shooters and stuff?
That'd be ridiculous.
Oh, okay.
Controller is way better.
If it's that,
I'm going to get hate for that.
No, yeah, you definitely, because a lot of people feel it's more tactile to have the mouse and keyboard for shooting. It's just pointing and clicking everywhere.
Yeah.
And, I mean, they tried it once a long time ago with one of the first-person shooters on the Xbox 360. And I don't even think it lasted that long, whatever that dumb game was. But I know you could probably find it in, like, a bargain bin on at GameStop or something like that.
I chose to opt out of the last MMO that came out, the one you guys bought on the Xbox. I'm going to skip the name. What was it?
Defiance.
That was the TV show. You guys hyped it up and said, oh.
Well, because, Nessie, I was all aboard the train for MMOs on consoles.
Hold on. First of all, if you guys don't know Aaron Carter does not like to admit his mistakes.
Oh, no. I admit my mistakes all the time.
One time. This is a different Aaron Carter.
Because.
That's the fact. I want to hear a formal. No. Hold on. No. I want to hear a formal Aaron Carter apology for trying to talk me into buying that piece of crap game.
Here's the deal. He probably doesn't know because he didn't play the game.
Are you talking about yourself in the third person?
I always talk about myself in the third person. Best way to talk about yourself. But the game Defiance, it wasn't terrible. It just wasn't it didn't seem like it was put together like an MMO should have been. I've played MMOs before. I played World of Warcraft. I played Final Fantasy XI, terrible game. I've played a lot of the free-to-play MMOs, and I've never beat one at all. Like, I've never got to the end game of an MMO, because there's a lot of stuff in MMOs that distract you from the main storyline or for the main mission.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Defiance wasn't enough of that. There wasn't enough side quests, enough jobs to do outside of the main storyline. So we were hitting that main storyline pretty hard, me and my friends, and we were just beating it one after another. And then when we got to the end game, the end boss was just like the easiest thing in the world. Like,
How many hours would you say the main story was?
Probably about, I don't know, 10, 15, about the average time of an actual action game, just a regular action game. And then after you beat the main storyline, now I know there's always more content coming out, and there's probably, I haven't picked up the game in a long time, so there's probably more stuff already, but after you beat the main storyline, they're like, hey, you want to just play the whole storyline over again? And I'm like, no.
Of course.
No.
Nothing would make me happier.
Why the heck would I want to do that again?
Is it at least like Borderlands where they make it tougher, or was it the exact same thing?
I don't believe so. You just go back and, I mean, the game is always tough because there's no real level system. You know, they kind of just go on what your weapons are rated and stuff like that. But it's like, I don't want to do all that grind over again. And there wasn't enough variety in the missions. There was a lot of co-op stuff that we didn't get to play. The PvP was decent. But, I mean, I've subscribed to them on Twitter, or I follow them on Twitter, and they talk about all the updates that they do. So they have new weapons, and I know they have new missions and stuff like that. But it didn't seem like there was anything really to pull me back on there. I still own the game, and I'll probably eventually go back. But for right now, I'm kind of just off of it.
I heard Aaron mention in their Twitter, and for all of those faithful listeners out there, I just wanted to remind you that we do have a Twitter account. If you go to www.twitter.com, you can follow us at @VideoGameBang. Shameless plug is over. And, you know, yeah, I'm glad I avoided Defiance, but I think Skyrim, if Skyrim Online can't make a great console MMO, then I will concede that it just can't be done.
But it's difficult, I guess, because if it was easy, they would have done it by now. They've tried, I guess, at least three times, because I can think of Final Fantasy XI, again, terrible game.
Terrible game. Why do you say that? Because I have no clue.
Well, see, I started playing World of Warcraft, and if you set that as the bar, that's kind of, you know, a little unfair to everything else. But Final Fantasy XI was the first MMO I ever played on a console game, or a gaming console. Played it on the Xbox 360.
Can I interrupt?
You go ahead.
I got a story. You, listeners out there, you guys don't know this guy, but he's an uncle of mine. His name is Jake. It's a weird situation where we're roughly the same age. I don't know. Maybe I'll bleep out his name. Yeah, I'll do that in post. I will. Maybe. I don't know. Anyways, when we were youngsters, he was really into that game. Because that was a PS2, right?
Yeah, it came out on the PS2.
And you had to buy like an external brick with a network
port
on it.
Yeah, a hard drive. Yeah.
Him and his family did that. So he'd be in one room, sister in the other room, dad in the other room. They'd be playing that game. They were into it, man. Like, it absorbed their lives. So much to the fact where he actually, his first girlfriend, he made on that game. That's when I realized what MMOs were and what they were capable of. I didn't know WoW. I didn't know anything. But when he told me, hey, I got a girlfriend, I was like, what? In real life? Like, a girl? He's like, yeah, I got a girlfriend. Here's her DeviantArt page.
Yeah, she lives in Japan.
She lives in Japan. I took her on a date to the Sea of the Alamos.
Yeah.
Or whatever
that,
they...
See, that's type of crap. When I played World of Warcraft as well, that was the type of thing. I was sitting there playing, and I was trying to do some mission or whatever, and I went and asked for help. It's an MMO. There's people everywhere. So I asked for help from somebody, and a dude told me, get away, I'm on a date. And I'm like, are you serious? I'm trying to kill scarecrows or something over here, and you over here trying to mack on something that isn't even human, first of all.
Or a woman.
Yeah.
The furthest thing from a woman.
Both of you two could be guys behind those keyboards, and you thinking this is another chick or something just because her avatar is, and I know plenty of guys that use avatar, like female avatars, as their, you know, not to mess with other people, but just that's, you know, what they do or whatever.
I know someone who does it just to mess with other people. David.
But that Final Fantasy game, though, like I said, I played World of Warcraft. Final Fantasy came up next, and it just fell short of expectations. Like, there, some of the smallest pet peeves were you can't jump in the game. And, like, it may sound so dumb and trivial, but if there's a small little ledge that's stopping you to getting from your objective, and you have to run all the way around just to get to the objective instead of just jumping the small little curb that you could have done in any other video game, you start to get a little irritated. And then the battling system, it seemed like...
Turn-based?
It wasn't turn-based. It was just like... I don't know what you call those type of battling systems where you go up to a monster and you click and then your character, you know, just fights for you and...
The WoW style?
Yeah, it's just it's a WoW type, but it's extremely slow. My biggest tipping point where I was like, I'm off this game was I had saved up a whole bunch of money and I had went to the shops just to get some new armor set. And I was so excited. I'm like, you know, I'm finally going to get some new armor. I'm going to get a different look for my character. I buy the armor. I equip it. And it's like a pink thong for my guy. And I was like, this is the strongest thing for me. Yes. The underwear with the lace on it is the strongest armor you got. So I was like, you know what? I'm done. I'm not going to sit here and spend more hours. And we had a coworker of ours, because it wasn't just me that got into this venture. It was me and like three other friends.
Was this the GameStop job?
Yes, it was the GameStop job. Another friend got onto the, he wanted us so bad to get on this game with him. He's like, well, you got to get this game. It's amazing. The game is amazing. So we played with him, and then we just like, why would you lie to us like this? We felt hurt, like betrayed. Like, why would you just outright lie to us like that? The game was terrible, and I know there are plenty of fans out there. I think I still even have one of my cousins play it.
Wow.
But they're going to make a... I mean, they are. They already have one. Another rendition of it. Final Fantasy, I think, 14 or something like that.
I think that one might be a PlayStation exclusive.
That one might be as well. I mean, of course, PC. It'll be out on that, but...
Yeah, well, PC. But as far as the console goes, and...
But I won't touch it. I wouldn't even... After the experience I had with 11, there's no way I would touch that game. I wouldn't even think about it.
Well, it's been about 30 minutes, so that's, you know what that means for those who listen to the program. That is when we take our first break. We will be right back with more Video Game Bang.
Same OG. Welcome back to the Video Game Bang podcast. Aaron Carter here with Corey Vincent. Say hello, Corey. Took a small break. Now we're back. We're going to switch topics just a little bit. We normally do talk about video games all the time, but something special is coming up. We have Comic-Con coming up, and I mean, it's similar. We're in the same realm. Comic books, video games, it's all the same, right? Yeah, right. That's exactly. There's a lot of things that's probably going to be shown at Comic-Con. Movie trailers, new comic books, maybe a video game here or there. I'm excited for it. I've never been to one. I won't be going to this year's. And I'm sure there's going to be plenty of news coming out of it. The major thing that I think I'm waiting to see come out of that thing is anything Batman, actually.
Wow. You really think they're going to have Batman
there? Oh, yeah. Like, I'm not... And for those that don't know, I'm a major, major Batman fan. So anything Batman-related is coming out, I'm just totally stoked for. I don't care if it's a new video game, a new comic book, which most likely... Actually, I hope they do more news about the Arkham Origins.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh, I was hoping you were going to bring that one
up. Oh, yeah.
Because... Yeah, I'm not as much of a Batman guy as you, but I do really appreciate those Batman Arkham games. If you have not played a Batman Arkham Asylum or Arkham City, you are doing yourself a major injustice.
Yeah, definitely. Injustice, the video game.
Oh, see what I did there? Totally on purpose.
No, it wasn't.
Ed Boon?
No, it wasn't.
Checks in the mail.
But hopefully, yeah, I would like to see some demos being played out of that. Some more information about the story, you know. I can't wait for that game. I bought the first two, and the third one should be, you know, if they keep the same formula, it's going to be amazing. I mean, like I said, anything with Batman.
I like the focus that they added Deadpool in there.
Deadpool is a Marvel character. And I don't know why he would make a cameo inside of a DC video game.
Wow. So, okay, the Deadpool ripoff. Then.
Deathstroke? Stroke?
Oh, okay, Is that what you mean?
That's the one. Okay.
Yeah. Now, what's Deathstroke's real name, Aaron?
Wade?
No.
Slade. That's what it is.
Is it Slade?
Slade.
Slilson?
Slade. Maybe Slade Wilson, the thing, maybe?
Because
no, it's Wade Wilson for Deadpool. Slade. Oh, I don't know why I'm blanking on this one.
That's how you know Deadpool is a better character.
Well, funny, yes. I don't know.
Well, and then just them changing the, you know, that was such a ripoff. Like, they know.
Yeah. It's making fun of us. But there's a lot of things, a lot of ripoffs from comic book characters back and forth. They do it all the time. I mean, it's I don't think it's like they are not creative enough to come up with their own characters.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, you know, it's poking fun.
Deadpool.
Yeah, and Deadpool, definitely one of my favorite characters in the comic book universe for Marvel. And it's funny, too, because with Marvel, there's a lot more characters that I like on Marvel than DC. But still, Batman is the reigning champion of, you know, all of them. So, I mean, when it comes to, like, the crossover comic books and stuff like that, I'm always rooting for a Marvel character to win. But
yeah,
until Batman shows up, and then I'm like, well, whatever about anybody. Wolverine, you're gone. Which I saw something disturbing. They have a video series where it's like Clash of the Heroes or Superhero Beatdown or something like that.
Oh, yeah. Okay, if you're if you want to get your fill in of awesome crossover live action battle scenes, YouTube, there's a channel called Bat in the Sun. And they have a regular series called Superpower Beatdown?
Something like that. It's either Superpower Beatdown, Superhero Beatdown. Super, one of them. You'll find it.
Super Beatdown. And, yeah. You go there, and they have a website, and every so often they throw up a poll where you give your opinion on which character you think would win in a battle. And then based on the people's votes, they shoot really awesome, maybe 10-minute fight scenes, usually throw in a couple hot chicks.
Yeah, really well done.
It's really tasteful.
Very well done.
It's tasteful.
They did one with Batman and Wolverine.
That was the best.
That one was the most off, I would have to say. See? Wolverine beating Batman. Like, first of all, they had Batman in an alleyway fighting Wolverine, and that's fine, you know, because you never know where the fight's going to take place. But then they have like Wolverine like wounding Batman, and then Batman just like cripples up in a corner and calls Alfred, "I need help, Alfred." Like, no, you don't. You're Batman. You would have grapple hooked out of there or something like that, and then got in the bat jet and flew your bloody self away back home.
Running joke between me and Aaron is, we all know that Batman is a human. He's weak. He can get broken bones.
Yeah.
And in the video game that they did, was it DC Universe versus Mortal Kombat or Mortal Kombat?
Yeah, it was Mortal Kombat versus DC, yeah.
Every scene where you have to fight Batman, you'd whoop his ass, and then automatic cutscene to Batman doing a barrel roll and shooting you with a taser.
Because that's how his character is written. I mean, it's just, you know, he can pretty much escape almost any situation. He's just prepared for everything.
I just pick Sub-Zero. I just beat his face into the ground. And then I do all this hard work. And then at the end, he does a barrel roll and shoots me with a taser. And then I lose.
He's and I think that's the way they justify him being around these Titan epic, you know, superheroes. Is because he doesn't have any superpowers. He just has his money and his smarts to keep him on par with the likes of like Superman and Green Lantern and so forth. But he needs it. He needs it. It's to keep him in the game, and he does it well. He does.
Well, if I remember correctly, last week you said you have no interest in a GLA movie because you don't think Batman could keep up with the real heroes.
Because no, I didn't say he couldn't keep up. I said they wouldn't. They can't find a way to portray him to where he could keep up. In the comic books, it's easier because they have unlimited, I don't know, quote-unquote funds on things that they can create. So if he needed a bat spaceship, boom, he's got a bat spaceship, right?
Yeah.
But if you were doing it on a live-action video or live-action movie, how do you explain a bat spaceship just popping up in the middle of Gotham City, you know, without smashing everything or something like that? It's easier to draw out something than it is to make it live action. And I mean, if they did something like, I know they're not at Comic-Con this year. They're not going to announce any new DC movies. Maybe they will. I don't know.
I don't know. It's possible.
Yeah, but I haven't heard anything or read anything online. There's tons of rumors going around that, what's his name, that played Robin in the last Batman?
Joseph Gordon-Levy?
Yeah, yeah. He's supposed to, you know, pick up the mantle and be the new Batman or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't think that's going to happen or pan out through.
I really hope not. I mean, I appreciate that it seems like the actor is down to do stuff like that and, like, really excited about the role.
Because yeah.
I hate when the actors get jaded with the role and they're holding out for more money and it becomes more about the actor than the character.
I don't even know if he's at that point yet. He's only played not even a Robin to me. He just played somebody that had a similar name. And I, spoiler alert if anybody hasn't seen, you know, the last Batman movie. But, you know, he gets the Batcave at the end. And it's like, okay, what's he supposed to do? First of all, he's just a regular beat cop.
Yeah.
It's not like he was just, you know, the top of his class at the academy or something like that. And he's been doing this forever. So you just gave him Batcave. And what do you expect him to just put on the suit and instantly go out there and not shoot people? Because first of all, he's a cop and that's what he's been trained to do. If I'm in trouble, shoot somebody. He's you know, it was kind of hard to believe. I think that was kind of I shouldn't have put that at the end. If you didn't want Robin to be in your movie, don't put Robin in your movie. That's fine. But if they do anything, if they announce any type of DC movies to try to lead them up to this JLA that they want to do or something like that, because of the success of, you know, Avengers, I would probably go with a Flash movie first. Somebody that's, you know, not as big as a Superman, but not as small as the Atom.
Oh, we're talking about, if you're going to bring up Superman, you just reminded me that I saw that movie.
Yeah, you did. And how would you...
I got to put the cans on for this one. Hold on. So, if you guys don't know radio lingo, that does mean headphones. The cans are on. That's when Ish gets real. I didn't like it. I stewed about it the last couple days, and it was just average.
Just now, was it because of the story or the special effects? What?
The special effects were the only saving grace. Special effects were fantastic. And there's going to be a lot of spoilers, so if you plan on seeing Superman, fast forward like 6.5 minutes. No, don't do that. Maybe like a minute and a half. Because, okay, better go for 2 minutes. Because, okay, where do I start? Plot holes galore. I hate when, it's kind of hard because they did it in every superhero movie because there has to be some crazy things. But there's a point in the movie where Lois Lane has this key, and it's a little Kryptonian key, and she's held captive on a spaceship. And she's the prisoner. And they throw her in this room, and they're rough. And they don't search her, first of all, to make sure she has anything or, you know, use.
Now, who's throwing her in this room?
Zod's goons.
Now, Zod's goons...
Like, his number two in command.
Okay,
like,
are they random they're, goons. They're Kryptonians,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So they have the same power as Superman, right?
On the Earth.
And they do not see anything. Because, I mean, he sees, like, everything. And they don't see anything on
Earth. Oh, no, they get around that. Sorry if I... My slapping scared you. Aaron flinched. Two for flinching. No, but there was a thing. Their ship held a Kryptonian atmosphere, so it simulated Krypton.
Oh,
so she had to wear a breather. She couldn't breathe.
Okay.
So they were kind of nerfed. But, yeah, come on. Use a wand, search her, get her naked. I don't know. Do something. I don't know, you guys, she's a prisoner, not a welcome guest, and they put her in a room that happened to have the little keyhole that she needed to put her key for Superman's dad to take over the ship and save the day.
Why? How does Superman's dad just know he needs to take over a ship?
He's dead, but his essence is in this key. It holds his consciousness and his what's left of his
So Gladiator takes over the ship, and mm-hmm. he just, what, frees everybody or
something? Yeah, he's opening doors, and he changes the atmosphere so that Superman gets strong again, because they have him in the other room.
Of course, you have to take away his power somehow in a movie, in a Superman movie, or it wouldn't be a Superman movie, right?
Yeah, and a huge missed opportunity in the movie is because they did a really good job of talking about young Superman as a kid, and how he'd get picked on, but he couldn't punch nobody, because if he hit someone, they'd die.
They'd die,
Their head would pop off. So he... there's this multiple scenes where it shows him just really wanting to lay into somebody, but he holds back.
But why?
Cause
not why does he hold back. Were they verbally abusing him?
Yeah, at one point, a guy threw a beer in his face.
And... how is that hurting you? You're Superman.
Well, he's still in his developmental stages.
Okay,
he's
so we have... like... adult we have Superman. Adolescent, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he's adolescent. There's this one point where these a bunch of bullies like corner him.
And do, why, okay, let's just stop it.
He's a kid.
It.
He's a little, he's, I understand. Like, he's still like
you're a
learning
kid,
who he is.
But you know that you have this super strength, and that if a boulder fell on your head, you wouldn't flinch. So when 12-year-olds corner you in a corner, You're scared. First of all, how do they corner you?
I don't think he was scared. He was a scared. He was a scared.
A scared.
He was afraid because his dad, played by Kevin Costner, was always giving him this upbringing and kind of had him afraid of himself. So he didn't know what he was capable of, and so like they pinned him down, and they don't physically. Pin
I was gonna
him.
Say like, they physically no, pinned no. Superman
they,
down.
They kind of like push him down and.
How'd they push?
Shut up.
this is a question I understand.
Magic. So he's like scared on the ground, Superman, and he's holding on to this metal pole. And then like someone scares the bullies off, some adults. And then Superman gets up, or Boy Superman, whatever you want to call him.
Superboy.
Superboy Man gets up, and then they show the pole. And
it's all
like,
smashed, right? Yeah.
How'd you know? Did you see it?
No, because that's the most predictable piece of crap I've ever heard of. And I don't understand. Like, you shouldn't have failed. Like, if they showed him walking backwards because, you know, he walked backwards and then he may have tripped on something like a pipe or something.
Okay, yeah, there's more
like
of that, I think.
Okay, and then maybe explain it to where he's like talking with his dad and he's like, I'm not afraid of them, I'm more afraid of what I would do to them. Did he ever go to any type of conversation like that? I don't think so, because
really.
Hollywood writers probably wouldn't have thought of anything like that. That's ridiculous.
The point of this was, though, they showed him getting picked on and they showed how he really wanted to deck somebody. And then there comes the moment where he... is face to face, and he like realizes, okay, him and Zod are about to get down. Something's gonna go down. He's gonna punch him. I wanted like some build up and some emotion in Superman's first punch, but it was just kind of nothing. It was just kind of like Superman just tackles him, and there's punches going back and forth. But I wanted like a big Waterboy moment,
like I can finally do this now.
I wanted to see the bully's head on Zod's head, and him just go just flip out on him.
I don't think they would do something like that, definitely.
Yeah, they didn't, of course. And then, okay, the end of the movie.
Just spoilers galore. I think we're like 5-6 minutes into Spoilerville here.
Yeah. Metropolis is destroyed. Buildings have fallen over. Millions have died.
Okay.
Millions. Superman's killed probably most of them by knocking these buildings. And there's a part where he's got Zod... kind of by the face from behind him. And Zod shoots lasers out of his eyes, and he's like moving the lasers along this wall towards a group of kids. And then Superman just, no! And just snaps his neck.
What?
Yeah. Like, that was what did it. The fact that he's going to kill, like, this family.
And he couldn't aim his head upwards?
He couldn't change the form of, I don't know, but he actually murders Zod.
Wow.
In the movie.
That's...
And then he crumples to the ground and then just screams. Aah!
That's a little out of character. Out. Okay, so then he has an emotional reaction to him killing somebody.
Yeah, and at that part, I go, oh, sweet. Next movie, we're going to get bearded, drug addict, like, listening
what
to
drugs?
Acid music. Like, because he's so distraught that he murdered somebody, and we're going to get this good emotional pull out of him. And then next scene, he's just regular old Superman, and they pull some funny joke where the lady says, oh, Superman's sexy. It was
That's terrible.
I'm not done.
There's more.
You think I was done. Then I'd literally look over to my wife at this point after the little joke, after we chuckle, and say, oh, man, I'm just really happy they didn't do have Superman put on the glasses and be Clark Kent at the Daily Bugle or whatever.
They didn't go into that at all?
No, they did. So I looked to my wife and said, man, I'm so glad they didn't do that shitty line. And then it happens. The next scene, he shows up for work at the Daily Planet or whatever, puts his stupid little glasses on. No one knows who he is except Lois, of course, who gives him like a little wink. But maybe that would have worked back when Superman was brand new. You know, he could have two personalities, two lives. But in the movie, his face was on TV. They have smartphones these days.
He's a celebrity, pretty much.
He's basically a freaking celebrity. And Lois Lane was, too, and they knew they were together. So no one's going to, like, track Lois Lane and try and find out Superman. No one's going to make that connection.
Apparently people in Metropolis are stupid.
It was so far-fetched.
That Superman, the thing that irritates me about Superman is every enemy that he beats, and it seems like it's the same thing with Zod. I understand he wasn't supposed to, you know, or he doesn't kill anybody, but every enemy he seems to beat, it's like, I'm just going to punch you as hard as I can, or I'm going to eye blast you as hard as I can, or, you know, why didn't you do that in the beginning? The movie probably would have been like been 3 minutes long.
Yeah.
Zod comes down, I punch you as hard as I can, game over. Yeah. And Metropolis isn't destroyed. So it's like, there's no thinking with Superman. It's not like he has to, I have to figure out how I'm going to do this. Even at the end of it, he didn't really have to think, like what you said. He was just shooting his eyes, and he just snapped his neck.
Snapped his neck, and that was it.
And it's like, okay, there's no super intelligence with somebody that's supposed to, I guess, have super intelligence.
Yeah.
In this character, so it kind of gets boring, and that's why for the longest I was saying there's no way that you can make a Superman movie that's going to be entertaining because the stories are terrible. It's just going to be a big graphical, you know, superhero battle between Superman and one of his super, you know, villains. But then you're just getting into a whole different, you know, stratosphere if you try to put the JLA with him and stuff like that. And
people new to the podcast know that this is a episode 2. So we're trying some new things, and we got a fact checker in here. It's our boy D. So if you hear a little rustling around, maybe some chair squeakage, we'll get him a microphone. That's coming soon.
But yeah, I don't think there's going to be any big news like for movies coming out of Comic-Con. I think we'll just be comics, maybe a couple of video games. I mean, there's movies coming out, but nothing. A
couple
major
panels.
Yeah, TV shows. Another one I'm excited for. Actually, TV shows is going to come out on Comic-Con. Is the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. or S.H.I.E.L.D. Agents.
Oh, whoa, that slipped my mind.
That one, and the first one is written and directed, I think, by Joss Whedon, and that's probably going to be the last one he'll do. And then he'll just hand it off to somebody else and just slap his name on it. But it looks like it's going to be good. I want to see how they explain the Agent Coulson thing.
Oh, yeah.
Another spoiler, if you haven't seen Avengers, he supposedly dies in that movie. But he's just like all out through in the TV show, and it's supposed to take place after the movie.
Oh, really? It does take place after
takes
the
place
movie.
After the movie, and how they're dealing with this, you know, I guess the new agents that work there or something like that. And they said all the agents that are in the show are totally new for the show, so you haven't seen them in the, you know, comic books or anything like that. You get a fresh take on the S.H.I.E.L.D. agency. It doesn't look like they're all wearing the spandex that you see them in.
They
in
got Sam comic Jackson?
Books. No Sam Jackson that I've seen so far. You know, I don't think they can afford Sam Jackson on the TV. What's the last thing you seen him on TV?
I don't know. Sanford and Son?
Yeah, like you've ever seen Sanford and Son.
What? You don't think I've seen Sanford and Son?
No, I'm not saying Sanford and Son. I'm saying I've seen Sam Jackson on Sanford and Son. I don't know if he's ever been on TV, period. I think he's just a strictly movie guy.
He had to have been on some TV.
Not that I can think of. He does a lot of straight to DVD
Not
movies.
That I ever heard of.
Yeah, exactly. He does a lot of straight to DVD stuff, too, that makes no sense to me. And they're terrible movies.
Yeah.
But he just whores himself out. And then he'll do one big blockbuster movie, and then everything is all forgiven. Sam Jackson is a jack of all trades when it comes to crappy movies. And I watch a lot of crappy movies, so I've seen them.
Yeah, to go from Mace Windu to Snakes on a Plane.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You have to make some interesting choices.
I don't know. He balances it all out, I guess. One bad, one good.
He is the funniest person to follow on Twitter, though.
I haven't followed him on Twitter yet. Is that him?
I think so, because he tweets just like he talks. Like, every one of his tweets you read in his voice. Like if he says motherfuckers or something, it's all like he spells it all out in all caps, so you just scream it in his voice.
He's an interesting person. I hope we do see him on at least one, like a cameo. Have him walk past one of the SHIELD agents and he's just too busy to do something.
Take some sound clips from other movies he's done. Exactly. Like he's on the phone, you know?
Yeah, do something. Because, I mean, people are watching to see the whole Marvel Universe come alive on this show. You
Agent
know?
Coulson will ask him, are you hungry, sir? Yeah. Say, a big kahuna burger. My wife's a vegetarian.
Using rips from other movies he's all been in. That'd be. I would even accept that.
That would be perfect.
Just put it on a hologram or something like that, and then have his mouth move while they.
Why does he have Jerry curls and a beard?
It's like this is before he lost his eye, because he has no eye patch whatsoever.
Man, when are we gonna get a Black Panther movie?
Whenever Wesley Snipes stays out of jail, that's when we're gonna get a Black Panther movie.
No, they wouldn't get Wesley Snipes.
He might as well. He's
already been Blade.
Okay, so what's that? Okay, so you had the Human Torch be Human Torch and Captain America.
Did your voice
exactly. It sure did.
And America,
I'm upset about that.
That's true, I guess. What about Michael Jai White? He would be the best.
He would be the best as I don't know. Like, see, there's all these black actors.
Ving Rhames.
Ving Rhames couldn't even be in the movie.
No, I'm just dating, I'm just dating black actors.
I was about to say, he couldn't even be in the movie. There's a lot of black actors that could do it, but in my mind, they all just kind of seem like they would just be citizens of Wakanda. And Wakanda is the nation that Black Panther is from.
So, but Wesley Snipes, do you think?
He'd just be treasurer. Well, no, I wouldn't put it in for the money, damn right.
So, you know. Taxes would not get paid.
Somebody that doesn't pay taxes, yeah, definitely. So he'd be in charge of something else. Michael Jai White, as much as I love his acting and his you know, karate kicks, I guess, I couldn't see him as the Black Panther. It would literally have to be, they would find somebody new.
Donald Glover.
No. Donald Glover, I like his rapping. I like his comedy. But then he just had to be Wakanda's court jester. That's what he'd have to be.
You don't think he can pull it up? You don't think he can get shredded and just...
No. Like, he's too small. He's too small. He's like, what, 5'3"?
I don't know. I don't look at people's height and weight.
Yeah, I do. So, you got to be a... I guess, have two different types. You'd have to have a commanding presence whenever he is the Black Panther. You know, because he's like this force to be reckoned with type of person, a leader of a whole nation. And then you have to have the younger version where he's still trying to figure out everything that's going on, because they have the Black Panther going that whole walk through Africa to, you know, get some experience, life experience before he becomes the leader. So you have to have an actor that can pull off both of those. And I don't see anybody right now that could, you know, black or white. And that would be really weird as a white Black Panther.
A white Black Panther? I'd pay. Of course I would, though.
Ryan Gosling as the Black Panther, everybody.
You know, I was thinking he would be a good Flash. I don't know if I said that on the last
one. You did, and that definitely I agree with that. I agree with that.
Sharp face. Ryan Gosling, if you're listening, you got a sharp face.
And he probably agrees as well. Sharp face.
It's in paying bills.
But the JLA one is. And if Black Panther isn't in Marvel Avengers 2, I don't know what they're going to do.
You know, I keep thinking of people who would make a good Black Panther. What about a Tyler Perry Presents?
That would be the worst, because he'd throw Madea somewhere in there. And as nobody Clark wants to see that. Nobody wants to see Madea in a Marvel movie.
Who's getting... Is this ABC's getting the S.H.I.E.L.D. show?
I don't know.
I think it's ABC.
If ABC gets it, it might be all right. Because they had that family superhero movie, or superhero TV show, right?
Didn't That's
they?
Right.
With the thing. Yeah, because we don't know his That's real just name. His
name forever. He should have known that when he took the role.
Michael Chiklis, isn't that his name?
He's got a stupid name. He's a thing.
That show was getting good, too. I watched all that on Netflix until...
They canceled it?
Oh, yeah, they canceled it. And it was funny because you find out that, you know, more spoilers... You find out that the family got their powers from, you know, are like they weren't the only people that had powers. This, whatever that goo or chemical that was sprayed on people was giving other people powers. And the last episode, there's like a plane full of people with that chemical on it. It goes down, and those people are criminals, and they get powers.
Oh, that would have been awesome.
And their friend, the family's friend, the black guy that was in the 40-year-old virgin, he is on that plane, and he gets superpowers. And the last scene is him, like, realizing, oh, you know, crap, I got superpowers. Show canceled. So it's like, the black guy doesn't get superpowers. That's how we do it. Like, oh, all right, we gave them enough power for this season. Let's take it away.
Gave them enough power.
Cancel the show now. Let's cancel the show. And I hope they do the same thing with this the S.H.I.E.L.D. one, because that's the one I know a lot of people are excited for. And if it does well, hopefully we'll see some more Marvel. Because we only see DC shows. Think about it. You got Smallville. You got The Arrow. Birds of Prey was a failed one, but it still was a DC show. So we've seen plenty of DC shows on television, but we haven't seen too many Marvel shows, if any.
Did you watch Smallville? Were you into that one?
No, I wasn't into Smallville.
Yeah, cool. It seemed like kind of a chick thing to watch.
But, yeah, like a Dawson's Creek meets Superman type of thing, yeah.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Yeah, that I wasn't... and then when I heard he couldn't fly, I was like, what's the purpose of even being Superman if you can't fly?
Oh, he couldn't fly in the show?
No. Apparently, he couldn't fly until, like, the last episode. Aww, so it's like, what am I... Yeah. And then he didn't even wear glasses. So it's like, we all know that you're Superman.
That's the... Man... The secret identity is so getting tarnished because of modern day like technology and stuff. Like even the most recent Spider-Man movie, that was one of my gripes, is that you know there's Peter Parker in the school, a white kid, first of all, dunking from like half court. Nobody's gonna ask a question or call a newspaper. Get this guy like a scholarship.
I haven't seen the new one with the lizard you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't seen that. And nobody, he wasn't on the basketball team after that or something?
No, he just, like, was punking kids, and, like, they flipped it around where he wasn't, like, the nerd, but he was, like, just doing all sorts of outlandish, crazy stuff that a normal human couldn't do. And at the same time, everyone has been watching this viral video of a Spider-Man doing the same exact thing to criminals, and no one even raised an eyebrow.
Maybe I don't know. Yeah, because they'll probably talk about more of the Spider in the second one that's coming out with Electro.
Oh, yeah.
And like, Jamie Foxx is playing Electro in that one. And then they actually
Giamatti.
They have Paul Giamatti as the Rhino. Giamatti. Yeah. Which
that's
I have.
Paul Giamatti.
That's.
I don't. I'm going to attack Spider-Man. I'm a Rhino.
That's terrible.
I'm sorry.
That's terrible. Now, Paul Giamatti is definitely going to attack you. Yeah. So you think I sound like that, huh?
That was pretty darn good.
Think I'm the Rhino? Okay, well, so I'll show you then. But he looks pretty sick, though, in that getup that he has. He has, tattoos all over him. He looks pretty legit.
I get a little worried when they start throwing multiple villains in there because I feel like they're going to neglect one of them, whether it's Jamie Foxx's...
Well, he's supposed to be downplayed, though, on this one because this is before he's actually the Rhino. This is whenever he's just the little Russian mafia guy or whatever.
Oh, they're not going to go into
him? Yeah, I don't think he's going to... I don't know. Maybe they'll say something more.
$10
Yeah, you got to pay your $10 to find out. But from the clip that they showed, or not showed, but the little screenshot, it just shows him kind of like gangstering out, and he's got the little tattoos and everything on. And
I'm a Russian gangster. He'll always be the monkey to me from, or the orangutan from the Planet of the Apes reboot. I'm a monkey.
Paul Giamatti, if he ever listens,
you're big fan of the show.
Yeah, you're really.
He's a big fan of the show.
He's laughing right now with us. But I know, I think they're going to focus more on Electro. I don't think they're going to go too much into. He might have like a cameo, but then if they do, why get Paul Giamatti?
Yeah, like,
why would you go with a big name?
Spend all the money.
You could have found some dude around the corner that looked Russian and put some fake tats on him. And the guy that delivers the vending machine items at my job, he could play
the rhino.
He's like a Russian guy. He comes in every morning. How are you guys doing? And I'm like, hey, that could have been the rhino right there.
In the Fox cartoon, was the rhino Russian?
No. Okay. I didn't figure out that he was Russian until they said he was Russian on the because I don't.
D was shaking his head furiously. Hell no, he was a Russian. He was passionate about that more than anything in the show.
Yeah, he was just a dumb hammerhead. Yeah, dumb hammerhead guy that just rammed into stuff for no apparent reason. I guess the equivalent would be Juggernaut. I don't know.
Oh, okay,
Juggernaut's not the smartest of bad guys. Yeah, that is true.
Juggernaut would smash him.
Yeah, oh yeah, without a doubt, without a doubt. Maybe they'll go into, speaking of Juggernaut, they'll go into that X-Men reboot that they've been planning.
Ooh, that'd be good.
Yeah, because I didn't like the first one was okay.
First Class?
No, the First Class was just stupid to me. That's
pretty bad.
I saw the trailer for it, and it already got me so unexcited.
Jennifer Lawrence in a skin suit?
I could care less.
What?
I could care less. Wow. You're defiling my childhood stories with all this. The whole thing was just bad. You had characters that didn't even need to be there, and
oh, they did do some funky stuff.
Like you have Havoc, who's older than Cyclops. When did that happen?
Yeah, and they had that awesome character. I think the one they killed off, the black dude.
Who's not even in the First Class?
Darwin.
What is that about? Come on now. And they even said he might sign on because they're going to do a First Class 2, apparently, which I have no idea why. But he might be back for that one.
I wouldn't mind that.
They said
I think his power is awesome.
Yeah, they said he might have evolved quick enough to.
Oh yeah, they could write all.
Get
that
up, yeah, garbage. They'll come up with something stupid. But I was like, that's. I didn't like that story. There was too many, I understand whenever they go from comic book to movie that they have to have writers make these things, but sometimes they take too many liberties with,
Sometimes just people be doing too much. And with that, we're going to take one more break. We'll be right back with more. Go ahead, you say it, Aaron.
Video gang? Nope.
No.
Yeah, because we're not a porn site, right?
It's there.
Back with Video Game Bang podcast. Aaron Carter, Corey Vincent in the studio one more time. Kind of sounds like a rap concert, right?
Yeah.
Wow, that's.
I'm sorry. I said it.
It's not racist at all, is it?
Well, the first thing you said to me when we got in here was, "You turn my mic up." just like every rap song I've ever heard.
It's turned my headphones up.
Okay.
Just so the viewers out there know what's going on.
Can you turn my headphones up?
Yeah. You got to hear yourself, It's not a conceited thing or anything like that. You just got to make sure you're on point. We kind of went through it all today, from the video games, the comic books. But I like that. We keep the conversation kind of spread out there. Don't get too rigid and everything like that. Everybody, if listeners out there, we still have a Twitter. Follow us on at Video Game Bang, if you got the Twitter out there. And we're going to try to get more interactive with that. So while we're recording live, because I know everybody downloads the show, you don't get to listen to us live, we'll try to keep some type of live feed updates. We'll get all that. We're still in the beginning stages of all this stuff. So, And then let us know, too. Feedback is definitely appreciated. Let us know what you want to hear, what you want to talk about sometimes, because we like talking about almost anything, as you can tell from episode one, from, what, video games, Xbox One, to Zimmerman.
Yep.
And those are two things that have nothing to do with each other. Unless Zimmerman shoots an Xbox One tomorrow, then there won't be any stories that we'll be talking about. So, yeah, we definitely want the feedback, you know. But it's fun trying to get more content out there. And then we also have a website, too. You want to tell them the website there, Corey?
Website is www.videogamebang.blogspot.com. We did just purchase the .com version of it, so we will get that running and something a little more permanent, a little more professional. But we're going to plan on having some articles, some video game, movie, technology reviews from a group of people that we hold close and dear to our hearts, the Yakum Clan.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. A lot of good ideas, a lot of bright stuff out, you know, from that group. A couple of videos might be coming your way, too. Just probably some rants, just in case, you know, the writing is up to par, you know, because there's a lot of clerical errors that I've had, I know, from my writings. Yeah. Gondo, David.
Yeah, expect, don't expect too much. If I could tell you one thing about this podcast, just don't expect too much.
I say, you know, this is what we'll do. We'll under-promise, over-deliver.
Exactly.
That way, you know, we can't fail. It's a winning strategy there. That's what I believe.
That's my life motto.
Is that what you told your wife? Said I'm a...
Don't talk about my under- All right, so that's about it. I want to thank Dominique Downs, a.k.a. D, for being our fact checker for today. And Aaron, as always, it's a pleasure, my friend.
Follow me at YDAAK, at YDAAK, YDAK.
And that is his gamer tag. That is his PIN number, more than likely. Yeah.
I think this is my work ID, too. Yeah, that's it's all around. Yeah.
And if you want to follow me, I am at RealCRV. I don't know how many times I could thank you guys, but... Without you guys, the show wouldn't be possible.
Yeah, as an episode two, yeah. 63 views.
All right, everybody. And as we like to say on Video Gang Bang, Video Game Bang? Is that what we're calling this?
No, Game. GAMEBANG.
As we like to always say on Video Game Bang, hey, we just want to talk about video games. Yeah. We just want to talk about video games. And we'll see you on the internet.
Later.